And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's really a great pleasure and honor to introduce not only a good friend of mine, but also one of the most experienced endoscopists in Europe. And although, Pradeep, you always say it opposite, I know how good you are and that you are doing the most difficult procedures and even the most difficult procedures in fibrotic tissue. And the problem is always when we're doing very advanced endoscopic procedures, but honestly not only advanced, but even the basic polypectomy, we sometimes really struggle with bleeding. And in this context, we are now very keen to learn from you about a novel hemostatic agent, which is a PuraStat, and you have extensive experience, published it most recently, very nice with your group. Congratulations and welcome.
Thank you very much. I'm delighted not only being here talking about it, but also by the fact that the enthusiasm in the audience is so huge. At the end of the day, we still have the whole hall which is full. So I'm really pleased to see that endoscopy is in very good, passionate hands. It's not just Cesare who has all the passion. I think our audience also are quite passionate about endoscopy. So I'm delighted. You heard a lot about artificial intelligence, and Pratik told you about real human intelligence. Unfortunately, I'm just going to talk about skills. So you don't have to exercise your brain. All endoscopists have skills, and this is the easiest skill you can acquire. So let me just go through very quickly, because we are all looking forward to the drink at the end of this. We're doing a lot of resections. And as we do more resections, we see more bleeding, and we'll see more perforation. We're not going to talk about perforation today, but we'll focus purely on bleeding for now. You see, this is not an unusual setting. If you do a lot of endoscopy, like a lot of us, then we will encounter bleeding. Simple devices like clips can help you. It's very useful because the polyp was already off, and now you got a bleed, you can put a clip because nothing else needs doing. Unfortunately, if this happens halfway through your polypectomy, it's very difficult to use the clip because if you put the clip, difficult to remove the rest of the polyp. We have some very easy tools to use. You got this big bleed, you can use other devices, but very quickly, before you can do anything, there's blood everywhere, you can't see, and you get this blunderbuster device, just blindly spray the powder and the bleeding stops. Very effective and can really potentially save a life in difficult situations. So it's a very effective tool. But again, if you're in the middle of an ERCP and doing a sphincterotomy and you have a big bleed, if you spray this, game over. Similarly for me, in the middle of EMR or ESD, if this happens and I spray this powder, I cannot continue. So it is very difficult to use this device for those kind of bleeds. So when we do this ESD for Barrett's, we do encounter bleeds. And as I showed you, I can't use a clip because it will stop me from proceeding further. I can't use this powder, because if I spray powder everywhere, I can't see what I've done, what I haven't done, and I can't proceed any further. So when we have this bleed in Barrett's, unfortunately, we have to use some other kind of devices. So Barrett's can be very vascular. The bleed can be quite brisk. You see there. So we use this another device called quad grasper, which is a monopolar coagulation device. You grasp the bleeding point, you coagulate. I tell you, I hold my breath when I'm doing this because I've now taken the mucosa and submucosa off. Bleeding point is on the muscle in the esophagus. If I overcoagulate, I'll perforate the esophagus. I undercoagulate, the bleeding will not stop. So it's a very fine balance, and you can always, there's a potential for error in this. So it's very risky, especially in right colon and in Barrett's, or in the esophagus, I mean. So it's not a perfect solution. We do not have a perfect hemostatic solution so far which meets all our needs. So there is an unmet need, and that's where I got attracted about this device. It is a device called PuraStat. Oops, sorry. So this is a fully synthetic inert peptide, which you can see how it works here. It's an acidic solution, very mildly acidic. When it comes into contact with blood or any other physiological solution, body fluids, the pH changes and it forms a mechanical scaffold. See there how that scaffold sits on top of the bleeding point, seals it, and then the platelets and clotting factors aggregate there and they form a stable clot and plug that hole and the bleeding stops. So I thought this can't be true. This is too simplistic. This is cannot work in a situation where we deal. But that's how it works. And because it's a fully synthetic, it's very sterile, there's no chances of infection. There was some data when we looked at, there were animal data in various organs they've used in animal experiments and found it worked and it was very safe. Then there was some human data looking at during surgery, during vascular grafts and during various colorectal surgery where the surgeons used inside during operation, and again that told me looks like this is a safe solution to apply. Subsequently, the data looks very small but kept on building up to give us more and more confidence till our colleague Professor Ponchon from France reported this early series of his experience with PuraStat in high-risk resections. Almost 50% of his patients were on antiplatelet agents or antithrombotic or anticoagulants, and what they found that following the resection, when they applied PuraStat, the expected delayed bleed rate was very low. It's not a randomized trial, there's no control group, but those of us in the business, we know that in this group of patients, you would expect around 6 to 7% of delayed bleed. So it looked like there's some potential benefit here. And then came this paper from our Japanese colleagues looking at gastric ESD. And what they found was the standard gastric ESD-related delayed bleed in Japanese expert hands is around 6%. That's very well established. And here you can see that delayed bleed was about 2%. So that looked very promising. They also added another dimension to it, that PuraStat accelerates healing following gastric ESD. So all these patients had gastroscopy at 1 week, 4 weeks and 2 months, and they found that if you apply PuraStat, the healing is very fast. So it looks like another potential benefit of this agent. You can see the data here in terms of healing. That's when we got interested and we started exploring this in our own experience of resections. And this is the data on our first 100 resections where we used PuraStat. And what we learned from this was there are different grades of bleeding, and PuraStat works in grade 1 and 2 very well, but in grade 3, which is a spurting bleed, an arterial spurt, it doesn't work very well. So we found in our series that almost 60% of our patients had bleed during the procedure. We used PuraStat to control the bleed, and in everyone else, we then applied, so all 100 patients had prophylactic use of PuraStat. And that's our data there, which shows that when we use PuraStat, 75% of the time we achieved effective hemostasis. The time to hemostasis wasn't long. You apply PuraStat, it takes maximum of a minute before the bleeding stops. If it doesn't stop within a minute, it's not going to stop, so you need to do something else. So you don't lose a lot of time. Most of the time it stops within about 20 to 30 seconds. And does not require a lot of PuraStat. Very small amount of PuraStat is required to achieve your aim. So these were the lessons that we learned from this. The delayed bleed rate is bizarrely, even we found around 3% in our complex resection series. So again, it's not a randomized trial, but from the historic data, it looks like the delayed bleed rate is a lot lower than what we expected. So it looks promising again. So the other lessons we learned from it was the ease to use. It's simple catheter, comes and you drop it, I'll show you in a minute, very easy to apply, catheter never got blocked, there was no need to empty the channel like how you need to do with various powders. So it's very simple use. And once you apply it, because it's transparent, It does not interfere with continuation of your resection work or your sphincterotomy or anything else that you want to do. And there were no adverse events related to the agent at all. So here is one of our cases where we resected this gastric lesion, and then you see this transparent gel. You just apply, use the gravity to your advantage. You start from the anti-gravity side, and the gravity will gravitate the gel away from it and increase your coverage. There, the entire base is covered. We probably use about half a ml of solution to cover that. So it's very, very simple to use. I can't imagine any endoscopist sitting here who will not be able to use. Whereas clipping requires training and a lot of skills. The skill requirement here is minimal. We do quite a lot of redos. This is somebody with a duodenal adenoma resected somewhere else and now has a resection, now has a recurrence. You can see the stenosis, the recurrent adenoma, which is always very difficult. And as you know, the duodenal adenomas like this carry 30% delayed bleed rate. One in three patients has a delayed bleed rate. So whenever we do this, we are very scared of delayed bleed. You see here the principle of gravity. You start and let the gravity help you to gravitate this gel everywhere else so that you don't need to use a lot of gel. So this is sort of our standard practice, because when you get a delayed bleed in duodenal EMR or resection, it's very, very scary for the patient, and it's very scary for myself. Going back and coagulating any vessel in the base of duodenum, in the resected base of duodenum, is extremely dangerous. So we do everything we can in our power to reduce the frequency of those events. Here is an example where we use during ESD. You're doing this ESD, you got a bleed. You can use cork grasper, but it does carry the risk of perforation because you are almost sitting on top of the vessel. Here you can see in real time applied PuraStat through the gel. You can see it was still bleeding, and now almost the bleeding is stopped. There's no further bleeding. You can see I'm just being cautious and applied some excess gel. And now I move away from it and do the dissection somewhere else, and I come back to the same site, wash off the gel, and carry on the dissection again. So it doesn't interfere and don't need to abort the procedure. You can get brisk bleeds, some of these brisk bleeds like this, and that can be difficult. We are trying to now control with the tip of the knife, which can be dangerous if you're not precise, if you use too much. We use the water jet. It hasn't stopped. It's still persisting, but obviously not helping. Now it's got even more brisk. This is not the situation to use PuraStat. So I'll advise you, don't waste your time. This is where you need your cork grasper. Act as fast as you can, grasp that vessel and coagulate it. So we then did a randomized trial during ESD, because those of you who do ESD, you would know the biggest nuisance in ESD is intra-procedural bleed. We see a lot of bleed during the procedure. That blood then muddies the submucosal plane. If your submucosal plane gets contaminated, your views go down and the risk of complication increases. And secondly, when you're controlling the bleed with any form of heat during ESD, your risk of perforation goes up. So in the Western hands, one of the big reasons for high rate of complications in ESD is this intraprocedural bleed, making us do things which can cause harm to that exposed muscle. So our vision here was to assess the efficacy of PuraStat as a non-thermal hemostatic agent in controlling the intraprocedural bleed during ESD. We enrolled 100 patients and randomized them to classical ESD and controlling all the bleed with heat, to a PuraStat-assisted hemostasis in the other half. And here you can see that the groups are well matched, the bleeds are well matched, and we found that during after my 7-8 years of experience of ESD, I still get about 5 to 6 intraprocedural bleeds per procedure. If I look back 4 years ago, 5 years ago, probably this will be around 10 bleeds per procedure. So this is just a sign of a learning curve, but this is where I am. This is where most of my Western experts are. So this is what we encounter during ESD most of the time. What happens when you use PuraStat? You can see here that about 93% of the time almost when we use PuraStat, it worked as a very effective hemostatic agent and it stopped the bleeding. Now you could argue that you're taking the knife out, putting PuraStat, applying gel, waiting, that's going to cost you time and you'll prolong the procedure. There was no difference in the procedure time. So PuraStat did not prolong, which suggests it works very, very fast. Now you could argue that you use PuraStat, it stopped the bleeding, now the gel might wash off, and then 2 hours later, 12 hours later, 24 hours later, the patient will get a delayed bleed. And that is a real worry, so we look for that, and fortunately, there's no difference in delayed bleed in both arms. So PuraStat does not just work immediately, it probably has some delayed effect, that's why patients did not get any delayed bleed in the PuraStat arm. I think this is the other secondary endpoint we had about wound healing. As a Japanese expert had already pointed out that in gastric ESD it accelerates healing, we found the same, that PuraStat arm healing was much faster than the non-PuraStat, and maybe this might have a role in the way it heals, in hemostasis, in stricture, all kinds of other things that come with wound healing. We don't know impact on those, but we definitely observe accelerated healing. Just finally to finish, you can see these are the two patients, one in colon, one in Barrett's. Both, this is a scarred lesion in colon, and that's another difficult lesion in Barrett's. When we do this, we always encounter bleeding, part and parcel of the procedure. Here you can see that in Barrett's, you can use the cork grasper, but again, risk of perforation. The lesion has come off in the colon. You can now put a clip here, but maybe you can stop the bleeding with the PuraStat. Because this was randomized to PuraStat, in both these patients we use PuraStat, and we see hemostasis within 30 seconds of applying. Transparent, you can see through it. It stopped the bleeding, and you can move on. You see through it, it did not stop the bleeding. You use cork grasper, you use clips, you use whatever additional modality. PuraStat does not stop us from using other modalities. We're now exploring lots of other uses of PuraStat. We see a lot of patients with radiation proctitis. We see lots of patients with GAVE. All these other vascular anomalies which are unstable, which bleed, and there's an issue with their inflammation and healing. Looks like PuraStat has some effect there. Our early data suggests that if you use PuraStat in these patients, you'll find a reduction in the need for transfusion, reduction in the need for, you know, patients with radiation proctitis get a lot of mucus, bleeding, and diarrhea. All that drops down very quickly. So another potential advantage, which needs to be explored a little bit further, but looks very promising. So in conclusion, PuraStat's very easy to use. It's a very effective hemostatic agent. It accelerates healing, and it could potentially reduce delayed bleeding. And I think there are a lot more indications beyond resection where PuraStat can help us in the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Pradeep. Fantastic talk as always. And we are just learning from a recent publication from our friend Eduardo Albanese, published in Gastroenterology, that clip closure after EMR is effective, however, only when we are really able to do a full clipping. Do you see a potential even of PuraStat in avoiding delayed bleeding for EMRs, maybe specifically even in the right colon? Could this be an option in the future as well?
Very, very good question. I think looks like high-risk patients following EMR can get up to 10% delayed bleed, and they've shown clip closure reduces that to almost 1%. Now, on an average, they required about 5 to 6 clips to do that. And they showed that about 30% of the patients, they could not close. So there is a lot of skill required, a lot of time required, and 6 clips in UK cost me about £400. So a lot of money required. So you've got to balance all those things. PuraStat has the potential. I think it needs to be tested, though. Looks promising, but we need to do a trial to prove that. And if we can, then all of us can use PuraStat. But closing the defect with clips, I'm not sure that we all can do that.
Thank you very much. So